I think the complex cases you are seeing since morning, I'll present a very simple problem, but it's a common day-to-day problem. This is also discussed and debated, so I would only tell you whom I follow, Dr. Samir Mehta or Dr. Cindy Grinds. This is a young patient. As you know, in India, we get MI at a very early age, chronic smoker, no other risk factors. He presented within 5 hours of ischemic chest pain, had an ST elevation anterior MI, and was taken up for primary angioplasty. Now, as the protocol, we do a non-culprit vessel which showed a significant mid-RCA tight lesion. This is the culprit vessel which showed LAD with thrombus. Now, we know about 40% of patients with ST elevation MI has a multivessel coronary artery disease. The options were to do culprit vessel angioplasty. We can do a multivessel angioplasty tackling both LAD and RCA, or do a staged. Staged only can be routinely done these lesions, or only if symptoms and ischemia develop. What are the evidence? This has been told. If you follow only culprit vessels or against the multivessel angioplasty, guidelines tell you if both the ACC and ESC, they attempt it in a different language, but both tell that if there is no hemodynamic compromise, do a culprit vessel. As was told, if you do a culprit vessel, the advantage, or if you do a multivessel angioplasty during the first angio, you may land up doing about a quarter of patients more than what is required, because many of these lesions are no more significant when a follow-up angiogram is done. This is what the observational studies which were alluded to have also shown, that the culprit vessel angioplasty is better in hospital, mortality is less, and this is what the meta-analysis of 14 retrospective and 4 prospective trials have suggested, that culprit vessel is better than multivessel, while the staged is better than a culprit vessel, and stage is also better than doing a multivessel during the primary angioplasty. So this primary culprit vessel was taken care of. It was wired. The post-thrombus aspiration and balloon dilatation, these were the results. The DES was positioned and the lesion was stented. Most of the time, if you follow the guideline, the procedure is completed. But should we leave that very tempting looking type A, discrete, tight RCA lesion, the patient is not hemodynamically compromised, that is the problem. Now, we have option 2 of dealing with this vessel also in the same procedure. The pathological studies say that the many plaques are vulnerable at this stage, so they should be tackled. If you go into the details of the meta-analysis, you find that if you look at the prospective trial, the multivessel angioplasty during the index procedure is better than culprit vessels. These are the two small trials which again suggested that multivessel may be better than the angioplasty. Now, in our center, if the lesion is type A in the non-culprit vessel, we also take up that during the same study. One of the slides Dr. Mehta showed, though in an exaggerated form, was that yes, the economy suggests that we should tackle the lesions both in the same setting. So I think I missed the slides. Sorry for the So what we do was we stented the other right coronary also with a DES, though this is against the guidelines, but I think this is the approach we usually follow. There are plus and minus points which have already been debated too. There can be an alternate approach, though it's extrapolation, I don't know how it will stand the test of time. If you look at the DEFERS trial, what they did was, if they found a lesion which had a lot of thrombus to prevent the slow flow or near no flow, what they did was they did the POBA, they put the patient on glycoprotein 2B3A and low molecular weight heparin. After 2-3 days, brought back the patient and then stented. So if you follow this approach in future, this controversy will not arise, because you will be able to deal with both the lesions after 2 or 3 days. But this is one trial which has suggested that this may be an alternate approach or a third approach which can be followed, though there are lots of points which needs to be discussed in future. So this is basically extrapolation of the third approach. This is not directly tested. So as was suggested, there are many other trials which are awaited, and we will have the answer. So I have just put forward to you for a teaching purpose what are the points which we have when we take a patient for ST elevation MI and how we tackle these lesions. Thank you.
So I was asked earlier whether I thought this subject of deferring or doing acute non-target lesion revascularization during acute MI should be the subject of the next very large trial, randomized trials. Anybody think it's worthy of a big trial, or is it that interesting?
I think it still is.